Marcel Beugels heeft van de Netherlands own of bemint and specialized in Power Query. This is one of the videos about various topics in Power Query that all share the same element, Power Query function a value type. This video is about a grouping and accumulation in nested tables. As a follow-up on my previous video, I have a table with bank transactions for various bank accounts. In this video, I will add a balance column for each bank account. We start with the query where we left in the previous video, the transaction signed. So we will have negative amounts for debit transactions and positive amounts for credit transactions. And we will reference this query for a new query. First, I will add the overall balance for all bank accounts, then I will turn that query into a function we can use to determine the balances for each bank account using the group by functionality. So I will rename this query in addBalance. It will be a function later on, so it will be the function addBalance. First thing I will do is drill down into the amount field and make it a buffered list that will be used to accumulate the values in the balance column. List buffer source amount and rename this step in amount so there will not be confusion with the amount field in the table. Next we go back to the source step. Now I can add an index column that will be used for the accumulation of the values. And now I will add the balance column. Balance. And I need to sum all the amounts up till the current row. So list sum list dot first n amounts, so that's the buffered list up till the current index. And now we have the overall balance amounts. Adjust the type number and remove the index column. I will now transform this query into a function. Advanced editor. Table is table. So it is now a function. And now I will create a new query in which I will group the table per bank account and add the balance column. So let's call this transactions with balance. First, I will add an index column as the original sort. And buffer this table before grouping, because grouping can change the sort order in a table. And we need to preserve the current sort order. Otherwise we get incorrect balances. So now I can group by bank account. Group by. And I will select operation all rows. That will give me partition tables which have the same columns as the original table, but now for each bank account a separate table will be created as a nested table. That looks like this. If I would expand the table now without a bank account, because it already exists in the main query, then you can see that all column types are any. I remove this step again. The reason for that is that these tables, so the each underscore represents the partition tables, and they are typed with the generic table type. In order to get the correct table type, we can use a function value type and use the same step as the first parameter of table group. So I will copy this and remove type table. If I now expand the tables column without a bank account, then all columns are properly typed. But we want to add a balance. Well, we can simply replace each underscore by add balance. And now a column will be added to the table, so I can't use just a value type added index, but I also need to invoke that function on added index table to get the correct column types. If I now expand the table without a bank account, then I have almost the result we were looking for. I will only move the date column over year, sort ascending on the original sort, and now I don't need this column anymore. Remove. This is the correct result, so I will load this to the existing worksheet, so I will load it to a new worksheet for now. Remove. Load to table existing worksheet over there. Do some typing, and now we have the result we are looking for. For instance, a GHI account starts with $456.06, and the next transaction is -$496.24, so the balance is -$40.18. So you can see that the balance amounts are per bank account, and that is the result we were looking for. So far this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video about Power Query.